Hello everyone, my name is Teriprism and welcome back to XCOM 2. Last episode we assaulted another advent facility and yeah, we lost two soldiers. We lost Ambroise Pare, who died while we were about to retreat from that facility to evac point. Thanks to Heavy Lancer coming close and attacking. And then we also lost the Kupuks, who tried to bring Ambroise's body back, and I accidentally moved him a little bit too close to Kelly, and he and Kelly took quite a hit from missiles from Advent mech. So, now that our losses have once again increased, let's go and see if we can recruit new soldiers. I actually don't want to recruit anyone just yet, because they cost a bit more this time around. But I might have to. So, who should we get? Actually, I have those four rookies I still have. And I'm saving them for that Psy Lab training. But on the other hand, I could get the new rookies as soon as that cost to recruit them has been lifted. So let's just train one of them to be ranger and one of them to be specialist. Niels Bohr and Max Planck. I think I'll make Satu and Rapose as our ranger. And Niels Bohr as our specialist. Well, time to head out. We got one blip out of Avatar Project by destroying that facility. Next we should... Actually, we are going to go and check a black market. Especially if there's Ellerium cores in there, we can use those. And also if we can find any new scientists here, those two could be really good. Lieutenant Jens Johansen would be specialist. That would be kind of perfect replacement for our lost specialist. Without need to retrain him. But superior repeater, superior scope. Starting to get interesting. But let's first get this these supplies, then I think we go ahead and get this specialist for us. To replace Ambroise. And I kind of want to get this repeater too. Now I'm going to go and take Johansen. And let's see what I can sell here. Going to sell about four of sectoid corpses. I'm not really into making those mind shields, because few times those mind controls have saved my squad members. Now, we could use that intel, but I think we are going to go and build this relay tower and then start heading out to new regions. Africa's bonus seems quite nice if I get all the areas there or all the regions. But what kind of bonus is in Oceania? Under the table. Little bit more supplies for selling stuff. Well, let's just start building this relay tower to get that extra supplies.
Setting course for Chile.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Let's go assign new research. And we recovered from 56 intel from that data pad. Not really happy about that, it was just too low. But like I originally planned, let's go with Elerium research now.
I assume you make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
And what's
Dr.
on the
Shen's
armory?
Constant vigil over my activities is starting to wear thin. I consider
right.
myself a patient man,
I
but
recruited that
she's going to have to trust me if we're going to achieve
Jens
our
Johansen
goal.
Specialist for us to replace Ambroise. Ambroise was going to be battle medic, so going to go through that route with Johansen too. And revival protocol. And field medic. There we go. He's good to go now. And back to scanning. Or building radio relays. There we go. Now, which way should we go? I think Africa is the best bet for us. And South Africa gives us more supplies, so let's try to make contact with South Africa first. And of course, as soon as I do this, I'm guessing facilities turning out in Oceania or some
Commander,
other place.
All of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Attempting
but let's
to
just start
local, regional
making contact here. And new targets for us to deal with. Well, we can get another scientist, and it at the same time stops that avatar project progress. So I'm going to go take that, just checking what I'm missing here. Yeah, nothing too bad. This is a one I want to stop. So, let's head out to Operation Demon Hand.
Setting course for the Western US Precinct.
And give me a moment while I'll set up our squad for this mission. And welcome back. this is going to be our squad. As you can see, I'm bringing Copernicus as our sharpshooter for this mission. Then also bringing Kailun as our main healer. Then Tesla as our combat hacker. Then going to bring Potelmaios as a ranger, because Kelly is still wounded. Then bringing two grenadiers with Kepler wearing his new exosuit. And acid grenade and flamethrower. And then bringing Bell with fire or incendiary grenade. So let's start it.
Deploy. We're in the pipe,
5x5. There we go. Let's start mission. Or in briefing
word
of the one.
Is Advent has been moving secure data vaults through this area on board their transport trains, and it looks like we have an opportunity to seize material critical to the aliens' latest operation. Once we've located the gear, we'll need to secure the area and remove any alien forces defending the train. This is our chance to slow them down. Seize that material at all costs.
Operation Demon Hand. Recover item from Advent Train. Looks like we're dropping right next to that train.
We've got a bead on the Advent data vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Hmm. Can't really see any logical places to advance other than through this side of the train. So let's start by getting our closest guys closer. And Copernicus on this roof here. And we found turret right away. Luckily we didn't go further than this. So, going to move Copernicus little bit closer here. Or, But not going to start shooting this turn.
Orders
just
confirmed.
Yet.
Moving out.
Next. I need to move Kailun, or actually going to move Tesla first. I might be able to hack that turret.
On the move.
Famous last words. And you can't even see it. So just dash over that full
moving
cover.
Out.
Good. Next, going to move Potelmaios. He can go next to this wall. And then on that half cover nearby that turret.
Okay.
I'm going to put Kailun on the bull cover on this roof here.
All over it.
Then Kepler. Following Copernicus.
Affirmative.
That half cover. And Bell can stay on ground level and follow everyone else. Actually, I'm going to leave him here and overwatch with him. Just in case there are some patrol incoming. Nothing. Can you hack it now? No, you can't. You can't even see it. I need to move quite carefully around it. I'm going to try and move Tesla over here. Luckily he wasn't discovered yet. Going to move him over here.
Heading there now.
And Kailun can hack that.
Let's
check what kind of chances we have to hack that lamp post over here. Squad sight for 3 turns or entire squad gaining. I'll have to consider that later on, once we've been discovered. At the moment, not that useful. Kyle, move over that full cover. Kepler could be moved over there, but that's not very good place. Unless we can get safely across here, then it would be better.
Is he go any more?
Nothing yet. There's a civilian over there. We need to get the Tesla up this roof. There, from there he might actually get that locker. And I can move Potelmaius over here without triggering that alarm.
Position confirmed.
And then move him next to Tesla, little bit lagging behind. Just to make sure I don't make any mistakes with him. Kailun will be staying on Overwatch. And Kepler will be staying cover too. I can rush Bell over here, I think.
Time to motor.
Moving a bit more centralized, which might be a huge mistake. And going to risk it with the Kepler and move him here.
Ricevuto, mi muovo.
And Copernicus, just stay on long watch. Same for Kailun.
Scary.
Overwatching. Not liking that sound. Let's see what happens if we move Tesla on full, not on full cover, but over here. He will be exposed there, most likely, but luckily not. But he's having, he's kind of having a great position there. What kind of chances I have hacking that turret with him? Let's see. Quite good chance to stun it, but not going to take that. Not yet. I'll be taking a risk and moving him here.
On my way.
Risk paid off. I could hit this, completely destroying this tank from underneath this, while the rest of the squad is on overwatch. They should be able to take care of this turret here, and anyone who might have survived from that first attack. Well, there's my plan. It's not very good one, but or actually, I need to keep a bell here to deal with that turret. And maybe Kailun too. But I think I can move. Though Tesla is in no good position. But if we hesitate too long, our chance to deal with that group with one well swoop goes away. Yeah, I'm going to risk it with a few of my guys. Namely Kepler and Ptolemaios. As our advance group, dealing with that. And then start with Copernicus. That leaves Kailun and Bell to deal with that turret here. So, Kepler on overwatch. Alright, Ptolemaios is on concealment. So, I will be rushing him here instead.
Rolling out.
Where is oh nice? Dear.
Advent troops spotted.
Well, there goes my chances. Especially with that exploding car. I'll be going to need this squad site now. Squad site. We are going to need it. Going to try this harder one. Yes! Whole squad has a squad site now.
I'm in!
For once, that was successful. Now, Copernicus, let's start with lightning hands on this turret. Or does this face-off actually need me to be closer to see them? Let's see. Yeah, I need to be closer to use that. So, start with the lightning hands anyway. And then let's see if we can move him a little bit closer. Not really. Only they are only ones that can move. Take care of that mech first. Or 88% chance to hit that and destroy it. Or killing out the Viper. 84. I think I'll try to take out that Viper first. There we go. One less to worry about.
Hostiles pacified.
And that still leaves you more chances. I might actually go and take care of that turret with the frag here.
Here, catch!
At least it took a little bit of armor off. I'll have to send this aid protocol on Tesla, because he is quite flanked there, and I need him to remotely hack that chest. Meanwhile, you are a bit too far away, so move a little bit closer. That's half cover, but watch out for that turret. And maybe you can now get them. Not as well as I hope for. That's hitting my guys too. How about frag then? Force them to move. Or at least that Viper. I need to take care of that. Let that collapse from this.
Get ready for a surprise!
And somehow I feel I'm making more mistakes by the minute. Well, we got that rid of that trooper at least. But there's that mech too. Oh dear. Potolomaios might die. Not looking very good for him. Miss, 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 miss. Oh.
Incoming over here. Objective.
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
And that's aiming at Tesla. Who took quite a beating.
No.
And he panicked.
No.
And you couldn't even save that Potolomaios from that Viper. Yeah, I'm not happy. Going to have to use a revival protocol on this. On Tesla. I need him now. Especially if he can see and hack that. Can you see that target? No, you can't. But you can do Haywire protocol.
Haywire's a go!
Can we get that heavy mech? Well, we could stun it and give us a little bit more time. That might be our best choice here. Better chance to success on get successful on this. I kind of want to do this, but there's just too small chance for that. And it oh yeah, these. These episodes are just not mine.
Can't get this one.
So how do I want to deal with this? I have this flamethrower, but if I want to use it, I would have to stay on somewhere around here. And that's not guaranteed to kill anyone. But if I move him here, and then launch frag some to get these two mechs with that acid grenade. This might be worth it.
Mi sto muovendo.
Acid grenade. Hitting them.
Lancio una granata.
That also removes that armor from them. Next, switch into Copernicus. We need to take care of that Viper and save Ptolemaios. Well, at least that freed up Ptolemaios. Now we're going to need to heal him.
Gremlin, medical detail.
Now, where do I want to move him? Maybe... No place is good over here. That Codex is going to flank us in any place we put him. And Viper's not too far behind either. Yeah, I'm going to risk it and try to get that Codex, or at least, if I take care of that Viper, I don't have to worry about it later on. 99% chance to hit. Or I could try to conceal with him and... No, that's not good. Just take out that Viper. There we go. Then we have Bell. We actually, this might be best chance for him. We might be lucky and get that heavy mega out this turn with this. Basic mech is dealt with, but the heavy mech is still left. Not anymore. Oh dear, flanking both of our grenadiers. Luckily, facing it on that removing ammo. Oh, Copernicus took quite a hit there. Going to have to move. Is that safe from that? Looks like it might be. Do I have... No, I don't have a pre-reload on him. and I don't dare to move closer with him yet before that Codex is dealt with. So let's start with Potelmaius. Moving to deal with this Codex. We might actually get it on one hit if we get that critical, which how often has it? Not quite. Almost got him, but not enough. And now... Can you get it with combat protocol? That heavy turret, I mean. Yeah, you can. That removes it. That out. Overwatch from it. Bring our rest of our group to deal with those codexes. Kylo moving over here. Sixty percent chance. It was a miss, but it was still enough, thanks to that advanced dock. Who else I have? Copernicus, don't miss this. Good.
Enemies down.
Now we can move Kepler here and reload.
Pronto a sparare.
And Bell. Out of the storm over here, a reload.
I'm ready.
Menace 1-5, the clock is ticking. That detonator isn't going to wait. Get
yes,
to the
I know.
Disarm it before we run out of time.
I know. Don't you worry about it. Now, going to move Tesla little bit closer. Hopefully he can hack it from there.
Heading out.
No, you can't. Oh, actually you can.
Accessing system.
Looked like you couldn't for a moment. Let's try to get the large catch of those alien alloys. Easily. There we go. Now just have to neutralize all the enemies.
Status confirmed. The charges are inactive and the package is secure. Eliminate any remaining hostiles near the AO.
Going to have to heal up our group a little bit. Tesla can actually heal himself, so going to heal Potelmaius first.
Give him a heal!
Might as well heal Tesla too, since he is quite exposed there. Now Kepler can move over there and stick on Overwatch.
Fatevi sotto.
What am I just gonna go inside here? Discovering enemies. Not the Archon. Would this actually work? I'm going to try.
I know.
Yes, it worked, and he can kind of move from there on this full cover.
That's affirmative.
Still keeping eye on them, but staying in better place.
I'm ready.
And you're not too useful there, so going to move you a little bit closer. And in safe place.
Closing on target position now.
Tesla is completely exposed once again. He might die there.
On Overwatch.
But got a few guys on Overwatch now. So if I'm lucky, we might actually take out this armor. But I doubt I'm that lucky. Doesn't look like I'm so lucky. And that's that shield guy once again. Hopefully it didn't give that Archon shield too. Looks like it didn't. Now what to do, what to do? I kind of need to take out this Overwatch so I can move Kepler to deal with that shield guy. Yeah, hopefully take out that Lancer with the critical. That's the way to do it.
Who's keeping score?
I'm spotted.
Draining ammo fast.
Yes, I know. I know. Kepler, you move. Can you get the? You move over there. No, it's too close to those minions. Better move there. And what are your chances to hit? Not very good ones. But acid grenade should deal with it. Not good enough. Not good enough. So, let's hope Copernicus can take out that Archon with this shot. Well, that was wide miss.
Not even close.
Yeah, no kidding. Going to have to move Kailun closer.
What's over there?
Can he see that 55% chance to hit? Going to save it just for a little bit longer. Going to see if I can deal with him some other way. Moving Tesla first. on this half cover.
On the move.
Fifty percent chance that might kill it. Yeah, take it. Combat protocol could be useful, but
not good.
No. How about the bell? If I move him here, can you hit it? 51% chance from there. Right. That's much better.
Hostile neutralized. I'm running low on ammo.
And if I move Kailun here, he will enter Overwatch from that. Well, that civilian might die. Like that. Sofia Petrova. Not close enough to trigger that Overwatch. Just Kepler, just take that. Or actually, who could use some experience? Tesla could use some. Same goes for Alexander Bell. Can you see him from here? If you can,
moving out.
Going to use him. At least trying to take out that shield bearer. That worked.
Kill confirmed.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Well, we got one more scientist now for us. That went a little bit better, but I'm still not happy how I'm doing lately on these missions. Welcome home. And Fel got that promotion I needed. Going to go with suppression with him. I haven't really used that demolition enough times myself. Valerium for superior stock. Missed shots still deal 3 damage. Amazing. Alien data catch and laser sight. And plenty of corpses once again. Not too badly on alien alloys either. And we got Archon autopsy now. And aesthetically impressive specimen, the hidden horrors of melting organic tissue with the inner workings of a machine are well disguised here. The unique melee weapon employed by the creature could be of particular interest to our rangers. So new ranger weapons. Commander. And we countered that Avatar project major breakthrough and got one scientist. Even less time for researching. Anyway, thanks everyone for watching. I will see you on next episode. Goodbye!